In my last video, I mentioned that the sun is really freaking powerful. And when you think about it, it's no wonder since the sun fuses 600 million tons of hydrogen every single second. That's like fusing the entire Mount Everest every 3 hours, or 100 Great Pyramids every second. That creates a lot of power. Let's put it in some perspective. Sun produces so much energy in one day that if you were somehow able to box up that power and put it in your car instead of the gasoline, you would have enough energy to drive to the moon and back down to the Earth. Oh, I'm kidding. You could circumnavigate the entire known universe. 6 times. Or you could just drive around the equator of Earth 400 quadrillion times. It's your choice. But we are lucky. You see, our sun is an average star. It's not too big and it's not too small either. The bigger and more massive the stars are, the more pressure they can produce in their cores. And this whole fusion process goes much faster. Our sun has a lifespan of around 10 billion years. Since it's 5 billion years old today, that means it lasts for 5 billion years more. But the stars that are much more massive than our sun last way less than that. We are not talking about a few billion years anymore, we are talking a couple of million years at the most. So in this case, the saying live fast and die young really is true. But let's go to the other part of the spectrum, the small stars. You see, stars like our sun and the bigger ones are so powerful that they don't have enough time to use up all the hydrogen. That's why our sun will use up only about 10% of the available fuel. 10%. But small stars can do that. Red dwarfs, really small stars, burn their fuel so slowly that they can last up to 10 trillion years. This time span is so long that we can't use the age of our universe to even begin to compare it. But let's try it anyway. This is the age of our planet. And this is the age of our sun. This is the age of our universe, and this is how much red dwarfs will be around. Our sun is a second or a third generation star. What that means is that in 14 billion years, our star was formed a long, long time ago. Then it blew up, spewing all of its insides. From that material, another star was formed, and it also blew up. And from that material, our sun was formed. So 14 billion years is a long period of time, even for the stars, but not for the red dwarfs. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.